Welcome back. In this stage, we'll take a closer look at Sanity schemas. In the last lesson, we set up this Sanity project and introduced you to Sanity Studio. You can see that we already have product, vendor, and category schemas available in the project. And that is because of the e-commerce schema we selected while setting up the application. So if you used a blank schema, don't worry, I'll go ahead and create a new schema to show you how it's done. To do that, let's go back to VS Code. Open the schemas directory and create a new file. And let's call it dispatch. To create a new schema, let's export a default object and give it a name. And give it a title. Let's also give it a type, and that will be document. And last but not the least, let's now define the fields that will be available in this schema. The first field we want is the name. Let's give it a title and give it a type of string. Let's duplicate that and make this address instead. So this schema that we just created, we represent delivery services for our vendors. What this means is that for every vendor in this project, we can assign them a dispatch service that will deliver their products to customers. So tell Sanity that we've made a new schema, and we can do that in schema.js by importing the dispatch schema that we just created here, and then register it here. And when we save, the studio will get the new update and display the newly created dispatch schema right here. If you click on it, you will notice that there are no existing documents in this schema. So let's go ahead and make some. Address will be XYZ Street. Publish that and make a new one. Let's call this one FedEx and give it an address of 456 ABC Street and publish that again. Now, we have two documents in our dispatch schema. To further confirm it, let's go over to the vision section of our studio and run a query to fetch the dispatch services. And here, we just need to change to dispatch and click on the Run Query button. The next thing we want to do is create a relationship between the dispatch schema and the vendor schema so that each vendor will have a dispatch service assigned to them. To do that, let's go back to VS Code, make a new field, and call it once again dispatcher and give it a new title. And it'll be dispatch service. Let's give it a type of reference, and it will be referenced to a type dispatch. The reference type is a special type in Sanity that helps you create relationships between schemas, which is what this field is going to do for us basically. It's going to add a field to the form to select a dispatch company when creating a vendor. So if we save this file and go back to Sanity, if you want to create a new vendor, you will get the dispatch service field, which lets you select a particular dispatch service provider from the existing dispatch services we have in the dispatch schema, which at the moment is FedEx and DHL. This will also apply to existing documents. So if you look at Nestle, for instance, if you come all the way down, you see that it also has the option to select a dispatch service. And this is a little about Sanity schemas and how they work with each other. In the next stage, we're going to look at the data store API. We'll also look at Sanity datasets and how to work with them. See you there.